nasty things to say about Hamilton.
They're what?
They have a lot of nasty things to say about Hamilton. So yeah. This is a little bit of our answer.
I know. You've been around for a while.
Yes, that's true.
That's what I'm saying. There's a lot of love there, too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, there is.
Okay.
that. And that's labor, that's work. Like, we think that sort of being a true self isn't, it's just something that happens naturally, but it's profoundly unnatural. And you make those choices.
Well, it's about the parts of you that you decide to talk about on stage versus the parts of you that you decide to talk about in an interview versus the parts of you you never mention. Like, I have siblings that I never talk about, but, you know, if I had 12 siblings and was a country performer, suddenly I might start talking about it. Is that me being authentic when the real me doesn't talk about it ever with my friends, but talks about it on stage, right? It gets kind of interesting at that point, so.
Well, and it's the daddy lessons, too, right? The memoir is that I will have people come up to me and just tell me absolutely unguarded stuff that I do not need or want to know. And I'm like, this is a crafted text. This is an act of writing. This is not an act of professional. And like Dolly, if she's on telling stories on talk shows or in magazines, she'll tell different stories to different people. It's not her being, it's her selling product. And one of the products is herself. And it's not a problem to sell yourself as a product. It's, God loves an honest whore. But let's make sure we know what's going on there.
I think Taylor Swift is an interesting example of that too, because she straddles pop and country. Much more pop for longer than country, ultimately. But everyone says she's just trying to sell stuff and that she's not authentic at all. But in her case, I don't even know what that means, right? Moving back to sort of the idea of criticism, I asked this. This is like the kind of like State of the Union question I like to ask, and that it was, what do you think of the state of music criticism currently in the West? Obviously, we're not, you know, I don't know what it's like in Korea. Sean, got any idea what it's like? What are the problems with the state of it right now?
All the while.
It takes me 3 weeks to get a check from the bluegrass situation. That's the problem with it. Noel paid on time, which is lovely. Everybody thinks they can do it. And they can't. I can't pay my rent right now. And we don't talk about that as well, right? Like, we think that, and the people don't think that criticism is its own legitimate form. That they don't think of it's worth doing. And there's this idea that criticism doesn't exist. We don't have the patience to learn how to read a text, it feels like, these days. Like, I'm just even thinking about, like, the DSC Humanities program from the university, that there's a long history of the essayist or the critic or the reader that people just feel like have cynically dismissed themselves. I don't know, I'm really discouraged, but I think we are the last generation who's going to do this professionally, and I think that there's an astonishing amount of work that we will lose because of the illegitimacy of that. That I think it's really important to read text, and I think that I'm disappointed if people don't.